Today, I'm having a look at a new power supply feature I found interesting enough to do a whole video on. Madness. But first, what's this? A Dawid Does Tech Stuff Minecraft server powered by our friends at Linode? Which we all know is the best Linux-based cloud computing and web hosting service. And aside from providing amazing Minecraft servers, Linode offers a whole host of Linux-y services. Services like node balancers, cloud computing, database management, and even Kubernetes, just to name a few. If this sounds good to you, sign up to Linode using the link in the description below for a 60-day $100 credit. Thank you, Linode, for sponsoring today's video. As you can tell from the box, the delivery driver clearly used it as a seat all the way from wherever it was shipped. The power supply in question is the new Swift version of Corsair's RMX series of power supplies. Now, as the loser that I am, I do not have the correct test equipment to properly review a power supply, so this is more going to be like a hands-on, but it's based on the RMX series of power supplies, so I'm sure it's a solid power supply, but do look out for proper reviews of it. What we're going to look at in today's video is the weird layout of this power supply. Look at that. On the surface, this just kind of looks like a normal power supply, but it's not. With a normal power supply, we have all of our connectors for modularness on this side. Whereas with this new Swift series, they've moved all of the connectors onto the side of the power supply. Now, I've immediately noticed something of concern. These aren't your standard Corsair power supply connectors. They're like new little Berber connectors. Look at how small they are. That's reasonably annoying, because if you have fancy sleeved cable replacements for a Corsair power supply, they're not going to work with this one anymore. You're going to have to buy new ones, which I'm not a big fan of. See, so it says here it's for use with genuine Type 5 cables, not the standard Type 4. Cable compatibility woes aside, it seems like a good idea, right? It means that you mount your power supply on the side of the case, and then you have access to all of your connectors without having to remove your power supply. But I do foresee some problems with that. It's right next to the side panel of the case. So is it gonna impact case compatibility a lot? Well, I guess we're gonna have to find out today. I also want to see what the cable side of this looks like. Oh, you don't get the nifty cable pouch with it anymore. That's a shame. Actually, I guess the combination of the small connector and the pretty flexible cable means it shouldn't take up too much space. I mean, let's plug it in. Yeah, it fits in there. Now that I see it like this, I'm not entirely sure how I feel about this. So I guess the next step is to try it in a bunch of cases and see if it works or not. To really push the convenience of this new configuration to the limit, I'm only gonna pre-connect the 24 pin before mounting the power supply, something which would be madness with a normal power supply. I will say the stock Type 5 cables are a definite improvement over the stock Type 4 cables. They're more malleable, and the 24 pin doesn't have that huge knuckle in it that's annoying to route. And once you have the cable plugged in, it's easier for you to use this pit of doom to hide the extra length of cable in, because there's not a bunch of connector and stuff in the way. That space is a lot more clear now. And with the new connector location, you're just using space that's wasted with a normal power supply. Now, if you ignore all of the other cables, you can see that we've managed to route it really nicely. It also comes with two single 8-pin connectors, not those weird umbilical dual ones that cause house fires, so that's nice. The more I'm using this, the more I'm surprised that no one's done this before. Just adding these connectors as you need them with the power supply mounted may not seem like a big deal, but I end up in this position almost every time I build a PC. where I forget to plug in one of the modular connectors. And 99% of the time, you have to unscrew the power supply and move it out so that you can plug the connector in and then move it back in. Whereas here, you just have access to it. Now, the general cable management still isn't beautiful back here, but that's more my fault than the power supply's fault. But with a bit of elbow grease, I could make it look way better. But cable management aside, I'm already real sold on this idea. But before I fillet it too enthusiastically, this is a modern Corsair case with 1.2 loser units of space next to the power supply, so obviously it works in here. But I don't think it's gonna be a universal solution, so I wanna try a couple of cases to see where it does and doesn't work. But first, let's test fit the side panel. Because of how much flatter I could get the cables, the side panel actually fit much better than it did with the normal power supply. So let me laboriously remove the power supply and try it in some other cases. Now for my extreme compatibility test, I'm gonna use the Ebola case. Granted, you probably shouldn't use a mid to high-end power supply in a terrible 7-generation-old budget case, but I had it lying around, so let's see if it fits. Oh, that's clearly not gonna work. Let's try another case. Next on the list of cases I happen to have lying around is the 100R. Again, a pretty unreasonable use case. Nope, it has the exact same problem. And I guess the moral of the story here is that any case that doesn't have a dedicated bottom basement is likely not gonna work because it has a solid metal panel on the left-hand side of the power supply. Next, let's try this ridiculous Asus Nezuko-chan case, which I think is a really interesting use case because it's a very short case, and with a normal power supply when I built in it, I actually had to remove this bottom hard drive cage for any even reasonable cable management to happen down here. And I think this new power supply may fix that problem. Okay, so I may have just spent like 3 minutes stuffing things in a hole, but I think even just with that little bit of effort, it's worked better than it did with a normal power supply. We've still got the hard drive cage in here, but we managed to stuff a whole bunch of crap into that small gap next to the power supply, and I think maybe the side panel will go on. Let's have a look. It does. With surprisingly little effort, actually, it fit on there. All in all, as far as standard modern power supply basement cases go, I think this is a really good idea that I hope catches on. It doesn't work in all cases, and with something like an O11 Dynamic or an H9, it still works, but it doesn't have the same benefit as in a more traditional case. So it's by no means as revolutionary as the invention of the vibrating codpiece, but it's a nice quality of life improvement which is not to be sniffed at. It is just a shame that you can't carry over older Corsair power supply cables, and I don't think the 10% price premium over the normal RMX power supply series is entirely justified, but it's not a huge difference. Either way, let me know what you think, and until the next video, thank you for watching. Bye-bye.